Yes, sir.
You are an arts graduate and completed your graduation, post-graduation in 2016.
Yes, sir.
In which subject?
Political science.
Political science. And can you tell what is the structure of judiciary in India?
Sir, the judiciary is the branch of government which deliver and administer the law.
You take out your
as
mask.
Far as the as far as the structure is concerned, at the lower level we have district courts that may be classified into two part, that is civil and criminal. Above district, that is High Court, then Supreme Court. All are working in a integrated company.
Okay. So, Supreme Court is called the Court of Record.
Yes, sir.
So, why?
Because its proceedings have evidentiary value and it is kept in record with perpetual testimony.
Suppose the citizen's fundamental rights are violated.
Yes, sir.
So, what options the court have?
Sir, Article 32 of the Constitution provides for the writ jurisdiction. It states that it is the right to constitutional remedy. Whenever the fundamental right of any person, any citizen is violated, he can go directly to the Supreme Court. Then Supreme Court has the power to issue writ jurisdiction, that is habeas corpus, mandamus, prohibition, certiorari and quo warranto to protect the right of the citizens.
Okay. So can he access the High Court for enforcement of fundamental right?
Yes, sir. As per Article 226, yes, sir.
226,
sir. Whenever there is the provision of High Court, the citizen should directly first go to the High Court. However, he can go to the Supreme Court as well.
Okay. So, coming to the same judiciary. So, how the judges are appointed?
Sir, judges are appointed actually on the basis of a collegium system consisting of four senior judges. And he is appointed by the President of India, on basis of the recommendation of the collegium.
So, what is the collegium?
So, collegium consists of a group of judiciary body consisting of four senior judges.
Only four, yeah, five. Chief Justice and four senior
judges. Four senior judges, yes.
Because if it is four, sir, there may be a tie.
Yes,
two,
sir,
two.
Yes. Yes, a senior justice, senior chief justice of India is also included.
Okay. Suppose the recommendation of the collegium.
Yes, sir.
Can the government reject it?
Sir, actually, this has not been mentioned in the constitution. However, it is held that the advice of chief justice of India is mandatory.
Okay. So, do you support the present judicial activism in operation in the country? Judiciary became very active right now. So, do you support it?
Sir, my view will be balanced because it is good as well as bad. Whenever judicial activism, basically the proactive role of the judiciary, when the fundamental right of the citizen is violated, then or the other part of the government is not working well, then judicial activism comes into play. However, when judicial activism is converted into judicial overreaching, then it will be difficult because we can't be ruled under judicial legislation.
Why?
Because we are a democratic state.
Yes, yes, good. So, your name is Balaram Das.
Yes, sir.
So, we have a program called Balaram in Odisha.
Yes, sir.
Balaram Yojana. Can you tell something about that Balaram Yojana?
Sir, Balaram Yojana of Odisha government is basically for the landless farmers, those who have not owned any land. They have been given the input.
Okay. And you belong to Khurda district?
Yes, sir.
So, there is a big controversy going on about the Paiko rebellion.
Yes, sir.
Can you tell something about that?
Sir, Paiko rebellion is an epoch-making history in 1817. It is considered as the first revolt against the British personnel, British system. However, the government has still not recognized it as a first war of independence, which is the people of Paika and people of Khurda is demanding.
The government has clearly told that this cannot be called as the first war of independence. Recently? because yes, central government clarified it,
yes,
that we are not going to recognize it at the first war of independence, but the expert committee gave the recommendation.
Yes, sir.
But the Odisha government has adopted a resolution on that. Do you know about that?
No, sir.
No idea. Okay. So, you'll be joining as an ASO.
Sir.
So, what do you feel will be your job?
Sir, as I studied about the high role of ASO, he is also considered as the guardian of the files. Overall file noting and drafting, all that will be first initiated through the ASO. And then it, after coming back, it has to be filed and different books and register will be maintained for the inspection as well.
You have interest in reading newspaper?
Yes, sir.
Samaj and Times of India?
Yes, sir.
Have you read the paper today?
It is reaching in my house late.
Okay, yesterday have you gone through the paper?
Yes, sir.
What is the main line? Headlines? 3-4 headlines of yesterday?
Main line was regarding the distribution of Biju Health Card Yojana scheme.
Okay, BSKY, smart card.
Yes, sir.
Okay, then?
And there was also column regarding appointment of the CDS is getting late.
Okay. There is a news regarding the CDS in the recent past.
Sir.
What is the news?
Sir, CDS was tragically got killed through the helicopter accident near Tamil Nadu. And the government process for appointment of the next CDS is going on. That's why the...
You know, what is the post of the CDS?
CDS is, sir, Chief of Defence Staff.
Okay.
He is the head of the military of Indian Armed Forces. He is mandate to... he is the permanent chief of the staff committees and he has mandated to construct the theater command which will integrate all the defense forces of the Indian.
Okay, good.
Balram, the ex-serviceman here, yesterday we met. Nahi Balram?
Yes, sir.
Who is an ideal citizen?
Sir, ideal citizen is one who is following the rules and regulations of the land.
Follow the samasta karyaku badhya. Ideal citizen of thinks of the duties.
Yes, sir. Coming to next. Yes, sir. Yes,
right?
Sir.
That is it.
Means constitutional values.
No. Nijara kartavya daitva ji aga bujhe, he is an ideal citizen.
Yes, sir.
And baki ta taku ta sob miliche seta rights tar aaj kichh asubidha.
Yes, sir.
She was the ideal.
Yes, sir.
Acha. Satya kono. Truth. What is truth?
Sir, truth is a wide concept, sir. Sir, as per the law is concerned, it is based on the evidence. But truth is eternal, sir. But as per human values and jete bele ame sabu kichhi ki chhadi dei ki ke
bolo. Gyani ki.
Sorry, sir.
Gyani ki, knowledgeable.
Very hypothetical question, sir. Gyani.
Ji, baby, khudu chhi aao gyanu kothi.
Yes, sir.
ये कोच मु सब जानी छी
नो सर
ओके फेडरल स्टेट बोली कहते ने इट्स अ फेडरल गवर्नमेंट
यस सर
कौन ता माने
फेडरल गवर्नमेंट इज सर वेयर द क्लियर डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ द सेपरेशन ऑफ द पावर इज देयर बिटवीन द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट एंड द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट अकॉर्डिंग एंड इन केस ऑफ इंडिया इट हैज द 7th शेड्यूल व्हिच क्लियरली डिमार्केट द पावर्स ऑफ द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट एंड सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट
They call they say that it's a people's government.
Yes, sir.
Really?
People's government means, sir, the people elected the representative to govern themselves, sir.
Is that over? Just to elect them and leave it?
Sir, in India, we have not followed the procedures like recall
people's
and...
People's government means, is Mo Sarkar. What is the concept, Mo Sarkar?
Sir, Mo Sarkar actually providing the social justice. Five T measures are being taken.
Then Mo Sarkar the concept for ownership.
Sir.
You should feel that it is my Sarkar, my government.
Yeah, I am participating in the developmental process.
More ownership.
Yes, sir.
That is it.
Sir.
Right?
Sir.
And people think of their role and responsibility.
Sir.
In the running of governments.
Yes, sir. And it can be possible when people will be taken into confidence.
Less of government and more of governance.
Yes, sir. Less government, more governance.
Good,
yes, sir.
Good luck, sir.
Thank you, sir.
What are the principal organs of a government?
Sir, there are three principal organs, legislative, judiciary and executive.
What are the functions?
Sir, legislative is responsible for making laws. Judiciary is there to administer the law, and as well as there is a check and balances to monitor the legislation, whether it is consistent with the constitution or not. And executive is responsible for enforcing and implementing the laws made by the legislature.
Okay. Sometimes there are hue and cry about judicial activism.
Yes, sir.
So what do you mean by that?
Sir, judicial activism is the concept of proactiveness of the judiciary. When all the different departments, different organs of the government is not working as per their capacities, as per their requirement, then judicial intervention is taking place.
Sometimes it is alleged that the judicial persons, sir, they unnecessarily intervene into the actions or the functions of other other functionaries.
Sir, it is true to some extent, because there is judicial enthusiasm which drag them into the role of the legislation. And various judicial legislation has been made in future where they have been forced, legislative has been forced to make law as per the judiciary.
Okay.
But this has been the judicial overreaching concept.
So now you are going to join as ASO, no?
Yes, sir.
So what would be your main functions, duties as ASO?
Sir, as per the duties of ASO is concerned, it is to provide the secretariat assistant to the judges to administer the administer justice to the citizens of India. In that process, it is the official keeping of files, providing timely information, then processing the files. All this will become under the ASO, sir.
Okay.
And however, preparing documents, registers, and maintaining all that for the inspections.
Do you have any idea about your promotional hierarchy from ASO to
Though I have not detailed, but I know you knew that is ASO, then SO, then superintendent, then there may be the provision of the registrar.
Yes. Good.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, then the inspired personality is Subhash Bose. Actually, what is your hobby? You haven't written anything. I think.
Sir, as far as
games and physical activities,
yes,
any specific game and sport, games and sports?
Sir, being a defense personnel, I have been played different games like volleyball, basketball, football.
Defense?
Yes, sir.
Yes, so
whenever there is opportunities and games, just go and
category
play.
ESM, what does it mean?
That is ex-servicemen, sir.
Ex-servicemen.
Yes, sir.
Okay. But why did you leave?
That sir, because my contract was for the 16 years, sir.
Oh, you have already put up 16 years of service.
Yes, sir. And when there will be the promotion, there will be the chance of extension of the service. But because of systemic issue, we could not be provided timely promotions.
Okay. So, what do you think that in defense, do you think that there is some forced discipline?
Yes, sir.
Do you enjoy that sort of discipline or you want a little bit more liberation?
No, sir. Actually, discipline is the backbone of the defense forces.
Okay.
Because where there will be no discipline, no force will be there. Because we don't have casteism and religious, all that thing is not exist there actually.
Mm-hmm.
We are one. We are live for one another. If one of my brother is killing, our brother is suffering, then I will be sacrifice my life for him. That was the concept of defense forces, sir.
In defense, what was your, in which post you were there?
I was soldier technical in Corps of Signals, which is basically responsible for providing communications in war and peacetime.
Achha.
Communication may include line communication, radio communication, and satellite communication as well.
Mm. But there are also, there is a very bright chance of getting promotion in your line.
Yes, sir. SCPs has provided to us. But systematic promotions, rank, next rank, that was delayed because of certain system issue.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Good performance.
Thank you.